Hello everyone. In this lecture, we will see or we will start with our next unit, that is structures in C. Structures in C. What is mean by basically a structure? So before this, we have gone through array. So what was array? Array was a collection of variables having same data type, but structure is the collection of variables having different data types. Means if we are considering, suppose one integer variable is there, one float variable is there, one character it is there. So by collecting all these things, if we are providing one name to it, so we can say that is a structure. So how it is declared or what is the basic use of it is, the limitation of array is it can store same type of data. When we want to store multiple values forming a single entity, then array is not useful. Such entities consist of different types of variables representing different values. In such situations, we need to refer group of variables with same name, then we can use a data type called structure. The structure is an user defined data type, as the user can decide how many number of or how many type of data items will be included inside the structure. So basically how the structures are to be declared, we will see one by one. To declare any structure, we need to use keyword struct. So struct is the keyword, and you have to give the identifier to the struct. Like we are giving names to the function, we are giving names to the arrays, same we are giving name to the structure. Suppose I am creating structure for a student, so I am giving name student. So struct stud will be there. So inside this, what I will do, I will collect all the information of the student, like integer. Suppose roll number I am taking, then suppose I am taking float, percentage of that student. So here what we are doing, we are taking one integer variable and one float variable, and these two are different types of variables, and still we are taking it in one name, that is stud. This is known as structure. So structure is a collection of variables having different data types. So see, here is the collection of variables. You can declare any number of variable. You can take float marks of 2-3 subjects, or you can take student's name here by declaring character array here, right? So these things comes under this. If you want to check, you can write here different number of variables inside one name. Okay, so this is the collection of variables having different data types. One is having integer data type, another is having float data type, and then we are providing a one name to it, that is stud is the name given to struct. And structure, know the compiler that this is the structure, we are giving struct is the keyword here, right? So to retrieve this or to use all these things, you have to declare one structure variable here. So suppose if I'm writing s1 here, so s1 will work as a structure variable. Means to access all the elements declared inside structure, you have to declare one structure variable, and that structure variable will access all the elements one by one. Okay, we will see one by one all the things. Next is, after declaring the structure, what you can do is how to access the data members from it. So to declare or to access any data member, you have to use dot operator. So s1 dot roll number, if you are writing, means you are providing suppose 4 value to it. So s1 dot roll number, you are providing the value to it. s1 dot suppose you are writing percentage, so is equal to 56.67, it will be the percentage if you want to write. So how to access the members of structure? So structure members can be accessed by using the dot operators. Okay. Next thing is, there are some properties of structure. So we will see one by one all the properties. So before this, we have seen that array was the collection of elements having same data type, right? Means suppose we are taking 10 integer variables in one array, so total 20 bytes of memory it will require. But for this structure, how we can calculate the size of this structure? So the size of structure is sum of size of its data members. Size of structure is sum of size of its data members. So total two data members are there. One is roll number, second is percentage. So roll number consists of integer or percentage is of type float. So here it requires 2 and it requires 4, means std structure requires total 6 bytes of memory to store the elements inside it. So what it says that the size of structure is the sum of size of its data member. Second thing is, a structure variable can be initialized like other variables. Like you can write here, suppose if you don't want to write such things, so what you can do here, after completing this, you can write struct s1 is equal to, inside curly braces you can provide the variables like 4, 56.67. This is another way to provide the values to the variables. By using this way also you can provide the values, or by using this way also you can provide the values to the variables present inside struct. Okay. Next is, structure variables can be copied into another structure variables by using, means suppose you have declared one structure here. Okay, and for accessing this structure you have declared one structure variable. You may declare number of structure variables here. So s2 you can again declare here, right? So suppose you are providing values to s1 by using this method, and if you want to copy these values into s2, then you can write here s2 dot roll number is equal to s1 dot roll number. So it is also possible. Same for s2 dot percentage is equal to s1 dot percentage. So whatever the data it contains, whatever the data contains by this s1 variable, that will be copied for the s2 variable. So this is also possible. So these are some properties of the structure. Okay. Now we will see one by one. Now you got the point that how to declare a structure by using the keyword struct. You need to give the name to the structure. Inside the structure, you have to write different data members as per your requirement. To access these data members, you have to write the variable here, right? You can declare the variable here also, or you can declare the variable by this way also. Here we have to write std also, struct std s1, and you can provide the values here. But if you don't want to provide the values while writing the program, you can provide the values while running the program. So how it works? Okay, see, we will check that also. So what we have to write is, suppose I'm writing here printf enter data. And after that, what I have to write, I want to enter the values for roll number and percentage, right? So I have to write scanf statement. Okay, so inside scanf, what I am writing, first I am writing percent d, then I am writing percent f used for float, okay, comma address of s1 dot roll number, comma address of s1 dot percentage, right? Same you have to write for printf statement, or to print the things, what you have to write, percent d. Before that I will write slash n so that it will print on next line. and we will not get confused. Slash n percent f, okay, and after that comma s1 dot roll number comma s1 dot percentage. Okay, let's see whether it will work or not. Yes, it is working. So enter data, it is printed here. What we have to do is we have to enter the values. First I need to enter roll number. Suppose I am entering roll number 23 and I am entering value for percentage, that is 89.88%. okay, so see, it will printed here 23 and 89.87%. okay, so this is the structure. Now you got the point, how to declare a structure, how to access different variables of the structure, how to initialize the variables. Initialization means we are providing the values to the variables of the structure. Thank you.